Those of you new, we've started a series of sermons on the Apostles' Creed. Last week we took the first article, that was about God, the Father Almighty. Today's the second article, Jesus conceived, born, suffered, died, was buried, and rose again from the dead. My thinking on this is that God loved us so much, he wanted to be with us. You know, when you love somebody, you want to be with them. And so God said this, John said this in John's Gospel, the Word became flesh, made his dwelling among us. We've seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father full of grace and truth. This past week or so, our daughter Siobhan posted something on my wall in Facebook. Whatever the heck that means. But somehow, Jan and I, we downloaded it, and it's a wonderful video about Mom. Now, I know we're a week ahead of time. And next week, Monique's going to preach on Mother's Day. It'll be her sort of farewell sermon, although she's not leaving till June 24th. And I thought, well, her sermon's going to be different than mine, so I'm going to talk about Mom, because here's what the deal was with that. If God wanted to be with us, one of the ways God would be with us is through our moms. Now, that's not to take anything away from the incarnation at all. It's an indication of, adumbration of, a God coming in Jesus, coming in our moms, and what you moms do for your kids. So it's a powerful video. It may bring tears to your eyes as you think about your own mom, or you think about how you've poured out your life for your own kids. But let's watch this really, I think, beautiful video, and I want to make some analogies. Hebrews said it this way, in the past God spoke to our ancestors through the prophets at many times and in varying ways, but in these last days God has spoken to us by his Son. So I want to draw some analogies that Jesus is a lot like our mom. And I'm going to just draw four or five quick things. Imitation is the key to learning. Julie sent me a wonderful text, Matthew 11, 28 through the Message. Thanks, Julie. Are you tired? Worn out? This is Jesus talking. Burned out on religion? Come to me. Get away with me and you'll recover your life. I'll show you how to take a real rest. Walk with me and work with me. Watch how I do it. Imitate me. Thomas a Kempis, the imitation of Christ. Learning from Jesus, listening to his words. Learn from me. Learn the unforced rhythms of grace. I won't lay anything heavy or ill-fitting on you. Keep company with me and you'll learn to live freely and lightly. Don't you wish everybody could have that picture of Jesus instead of the one encrusted with all kinds of religious distortions? So the first thing I want to say is imitation is key to learning. There's a wonderful and powerful TED video. I forget what the initials TED mean, but the TED video is of a couple who I think are students or professors at MIT, and they want to learn how their child learns to talk. What goes into that very, very complicated thing of learning to talk and walk? So they rig the house, every room in their house with cameras of sound, and they take pictures all the time, 24 hours a day. And then with their ability, they streamline it. So they begin to hear this child's first syllables coming out. And they're trying to discern how we do that. And clearly it's through imitating our moms, our dads. And that's what Jesus is saying. Imitate me. Learn of me. And I just want to encourage you today to sort of block out all the other voices. Go to Jesus, the Sermon on the Mount, wherever. Listen to him. Learn of him. Let him help you. Learn from him. The other thing is, Jan and I think we're curious, worried a little bit about how our own two grandchildren in Virginia would learn to walk. Because as many of you know, our daughter's in a wheelchair 99% of the time. If you watch somebody walk, and that's how you learn how to walk, what would happen to them? Now, they've learned how to walk. They watch their dad, they watch others. I don't know exactly all the mechanics of this, but we learn by imitating. So that's the first thing I would say to you. Let your mom help you. Let Jesus help you. Do you notice in that video, the mom is there cheering on and getting them up and walking, taking them to practice, all of those sorts of things. I just want to encourage you today, let Jesus help you too. You may be struggling through a hard, difficult thing, but let him help you. He wants to come alongside of you, just like this Matthew 11 says, come alongside me. I want to be with you. Draw on my strength. Just as your mom's there with you, let me be there with you. Just as your mom gets you up, let me get you up out of that tough time you're in right now. That's the second thing. You look a lot alike. You know, you look like your parents. I hate to break that to some of you, but that's the truth. And your kids look like you. And what? Anybody know who that guy is? Hey, Zach Ayala over there. This is P.K. Young won the districts. And that was in the paper the other day. I said, Alice, can I show that on? Doesn't he look a lot like Alice? So there you go, Zach. They scored a run there. Anyway, you look a lot alike. So you and I are created in the image of God. The image of God, that means that we have the capacity to love and to serve and to think and create. Now we learn that image got tainted, but Jesus can restore that as we invite him to, as we ask him to, as we ask him to come in and work his wonder-working power within us. But you look a lot like your mom. Now I have a confession to make to you. Now some of you just woke up when you heard the preacher has a confession to make. It's not too juicy, but I like to watch Dancing with the Stars. I just tell you, I like to watch. Isn't that awful? I mean, I hope you don't think less of me. But at any rate, I like that show. I like that show. 2 weeks ago on the second night when they kick people off, I forget what it's called, the second night. At any rate, what's it called? You aren't going to admit it. Okay. So they have these powerful stories about, like last week was about a, well, anyway, 2 weeks ago, was about a little girl who grew up, was born in Sierra Leone, and a victim of that awful civil war there in Sierra Leone. And somehow in the midst of that, she got a disease or an illness that made her dark skin blotchy white all around. what you could see. And she said, nobody wanted me. I was known as the devil's child. But a couple from New York adopted her and another girl. And they interviewed the mom. And the mom said, whatever she'd be doing, she just loved to dance. And they had the means to put her in ballet. And she was currently one of the shining stars in the Jacqueline Kennedy Onassis School of Ballet. And she danced this amazing dance on the Dancing with the Stars. She didn't look like her mom, but she was a lot like her mom. And you and I are created in God's image, and I just say to you today, live into the image. Live into the image God has created you to be. Fourth, mom pours herself out for you. In fact, it may be a kind of a word of caution to moms. I don't know how you pull back on what you are innately wired to do, but somehow make sure you plan in such a way that when your kids grow, you still have a life, because you tend to pour yourself in. Jesus poured himself out for us. Psalm 22 says, I have poured myself out. I'm poured out like an empty vessel. Philippians chapter 2 says, he was in the form of God. This is about Jesus. Thought equality with God not something to be grasped, but he emptied himself. Emptied himself. Became sin for us. Poured himself out for us that we might be brought back home to God. And then finally, she says sometimes it's time to come to the table. One of the most wonderful things, but many of the wonderful things mom would say is about 6 o'clock, come out on the back of the porch, front of the porch, and yell out across the field or through the barn, it's supper time. Come on in. The table's ready. You come and you sit at the table and you go over your day and you remember and you experience grace because you haven't done much generally to put the food there, but your mom or dad has. You experience this overwhelming sense of grace and gratitude. And we come today to this table. And we experience forgiveness because we make our confession. Jesus, you know me. You know me really, really well. And so I make my confession about what I've done, ask your forgiveness. And he says, I forgive you and I receive you and I now pour my life into you. Eat and drink. Body of Christ, the blood of Christ, broken and shed for you. And so that's what we're doing today. Would you pray with me? Almighty and loving God, we thank you for moms in and of themselves, but because they point beyond them to you, to your son Jesus, who shows us what you're like and that you love us so much. So be known to us now as we break bread and drink the cup. Forgive us. Receive us. In the name of Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen.